We have seen some problem related to the integrator. Now, today we are going to discuss about the logarithmic amplifier. Logarithmic amplifier is generally a mathematical topic where we need to calculate the value of output, where the output is the logarithmic of the input signal voltage. So this is the basic fundamental of the logarithmic amplifier. Just simply as we do in case of the normal mathematics for the calculation of log, here with the help of some electronic circuit, or basically with the help of op amp, we will see how to calculate the value of output. So this is our main topic of today's lecture. So the logarithmic amplifier. So logarithmic amplifier, or it can also be said as the log amplifier, is an electronic circuit which is generally used to produce the output that is proportional to the logarithmic of the input signal voltage. So here with the help of log amplifier, we will get the output, and the value of that output will be log of the input signal voltage. So this is the basic fundamental of logarithmic amplifier. Now, how can we design this logarithmic amplifier? So there are two different kinds of the circuit we can use for the design of log amplifier. First circuit is, as you can see over here in the left side of the panel, either you can use the diode. So that if the diode is connected in the feedback element, in case of using with the help of operational amplifier, so this is one of the method by which we can design the log amplifier. That is also called as the logarithmic amplifier using diode. So either we can design the log amplifier using diode, or we can design the logarithmic amplifier using transistor. Basic difference in between log amplifier using diode and the log amplifier using transistor is only that the connection of the feedback element. In case of diode, feedback will be given with the help of diode, and in case of the transistor, at the feedback element, transistor would be connected. So this is the basic circuit difference for the design of the logarithmic amplifier circuit. So now today, one by one, we will discuss, first of all, we will discuss about the logarithmic amplifier using diode. We will derive the expression for the output in case of the diode. Then after that, we will see some temperature compensation. If there is some chances to compensate the value of temperature, if the electronic circuit is affected by some temperature component, then we will see how can we rectify that particular problem. Then after that, we will see the operation with the help of transistor. In case of transistor also, we will derive the expression for the output and the temperature compensation. So only we will discuss about the logarithmic amplifier as per your syllabus. We will not discuss about the anti-log amplifier. Why? Because anti-log amplifier is not in your curriculum. So only we are going to discuss about the log amplifier. So first of all, we are starting with logarithmic amplifier using diode. So the basic fundamental for the designing of log amplifier using diode. So as you know, already you have studied it in EDC, the VI relationship of the diode is represented at this equation number 1, where the value of current I will be how much? I naught e to the power V divided by eta VT minus 1. So that is the value of diode, where I naught is reverse saturation current. This I naught is what? Reverse saturation current. The value of eta is equal to either 1 or 2. If we are using the, it depends which kind of material we are using. So in general, we take the value of eta is equal to 1 in most of the calculation purpose, or for the particular problem, the value of eta would be given to you. Vt is thermal voltage, and the value of this thermal voltage is equal to what? Vt is equal to kT divided by Q. Vt is what? Vt is equal to kT divided by Q. Where K is Boltzmann constant, T is temperature, and Q is electronic charge. That means this Vt is temperature dependent component. This Vt is what? Vt is temperature dependent. And if at the output terminal this Vt would be present, then we need to use some methodology for rectifying this particular term from the output. In general, the value of this thermal voltage is how much? 25 millivolts. So that is the value of this thermal voltage. So now, in case of diode, this V is what? V is the voltage across the diode. Let it is represented as Vd. So V is equal to Vd, and let I is equal to Ia. Why? Because here we have chosen that this diode is connected in the feedback path, and let the value of feedback current is noted as IF. So I is equal to IF, which is nothing but the diode current, and the value of V is equal to diode voltage, which is represented as VD. Now substituting these values in equation number one, so from there IF will be equal to I naught e to the power beta divided by VD divided by eta VT. We are neglecting here the value of minus 1. Why? Because the value of VD divided by eta VT, this whole term is much, much greater than 1. The value of this term is much, much greater than 1. That's why only we are choosing here e to the power VD divided by eta VT. Now, finally, we need to calculate the value of output. That means we need to calculate the value of VD. So for the calculation of that, we are taking the natural log. So taking the natural log, so log IF is equal to log I naught e to the power VD divided by eta VT. After some simplification, you will get the final value of VD, as you can do with this simplification. Huh? So after this simplification, you will get the value of VD as eta VT log IF divided by I naught. So this is the value of diode voltage. So why we are going to calculate here the value of VD? Why? Because this is in general an inverting amplifier. If suppose in case of the diode, if we replace it by the resistance, then only if we know the value of total voltage drop across this, then from there we can easily calculate the value of output. So first of all, with the help of this fundamental logic, we are calculating the value of total voltage drop in feedback element. When we know the value of this feedback voltage, then easily with the help of inverting amplifier also we can calculate the value of output. So this is our basic fundamental for the calculation of the output. So the value of VD is what? VD is equal to eta VT log IF by I naught, where IF is diode current, which is also here it name as the feedback current. I naught is reverse saturation current. VT is thermal voltage and eta is constant. So this is the value of diode voltage. Now, when we are considering the transistor, so one by one, first of all, we are discussing the fundamental voltage or the total voltage drop across the transistor and diode. So now we are going to discuss what could be the value of total voltage across this transistor. Why? Because when we are using the logarithmic amplifier using transistor, on that condition also we need to calculate the total voltage drop in feedback path. So already we have calculated the value of VD when we have designed the logarithmic amplifier using diode. Now, total feedback voltage when we are using the transistor. So the expression for the collector current is same as the diode current also. So by using the same concept, the value of IC is what when we are using the transistor? Collector current will be nothing but alpha into IS, where IS is emitter saturation current. So IC is equal to alpha IS e to the power VBE divided by beta minus 1. So one query will be in your mind, why it is VBE? In general, as per the formula, the value is V. What is V? V is the total voltage drop in feedback element. We have represented this V in terms of VBE. Why? Because from this particular terminal to here, the value of voltage is what? This is C, this is B. That means total voltage drop here will be VCB. Here total voltage drop is how much? VCB. And here total voltage drop V. So total voltage V will be equal to VCB plus VBE. So the addition of these two voltages will be equal to your total voltage across the transistor. But what is this VCB? You can see that the base terminal of transistor is grounded. Base terminal of this transistor is grounded and collector terminal is connected to the inverting terminal of op amp. That means at node B, and node B is virtually connected to node A, and node A is also grounded. That means node B is also grounded. So base terminal as well as collector terminal, both are connected to zero potential. That's why the value of VCB is equal to zero. So when VCB is equal to zero, so V will be equal to only VBE only. That's why we have replaced here the value of V is equal to VBE. I think that would be clear to all of you. Yeah? So the value of IC is equal to how much? Alpha into IS e to the power VBE divided by VT minus 1. In case of, why In case here in general we take the value of alpha is equal to 1. The value of alpha is equal to 1. So when the value of alpha is equal to 1, so the expression would be IC divided by IS e to the power VBE divided by VT. Again, here we are neglecting the value of minus 1. The reason is same. The value of e to the power VBE divided by beta, VT is much greater than 1. That's why here we are taking this term only. So the value of IC divided by IS is equal to this one. Now what we need to do? We are going to calculate the value of output. What is output here? Output is nothing but the feedback voltage. And here feedback voltage is what? Feedback voltage is nothing but the VBE voltage in case of the transistor. So now we need to calculate the value of this VBE. So for calculation of this VBE, now we are taking the natural log in both the sides. So by taking the natural log, so log IC divided by IS will be equal to log e to the power VBE divided by VT. Now calculate. After simplification, this is the final value of VBE. So VBE will be equal to VT log IC divided by IS, where IC is collector current and IS is emitter reverse saturation current. IS is what? Emitter terminal reverse saturation current. So we have calculated the value of diode voltage. Already we have calculated the value of feedback voltage in case of the transistor. Now we are in a condition to calculate the final output voltage of the logarithmic amplifier in case of the diode or in case of the transistor. So for that we will use this equation number A. So this equation was the diode voltage. Now when we use the diode in the feedback element, this equation number is B. So this B will be used for the calculation of the output in case of the transistor. So now moving further, for the calculation of output voltage of the logarithmic amplifier when we are using the diode. So logarithmic amplifier when we are using the diode. So here let the value of input current is I. Here the value of input current is I. Let this terminal is A, this terminal is B. IF is the feedback current or the diode current, and this is your output terminal. As the direction of the current is from here to there, so it will be plus minus. This will also be equal to plus minus, and output will be also be equal to plus minus as per the direction of the current. Now what is the value of I? I will be equal to voltage drop across this resistance R1. Here it is R, here it is R1. Let's suppose it is R1. Let this R1. So Vn minus Va divided by R, that is the value of I. Or as Va is connected to Vb and Vb is connected to ground by the same concept of virtual ground, so Va is equal to 0. So when Va is equal to 0, I will be equal to Vn divided by R. So that is the value of current I. Now what is IF? IF is equal to I. Why? Because the value of II, input current to the operational amplifier, is equal to 0. Why? Because infinite resistance. R input resistance of the op amp is infinite. So the value of II is equal to 0. So when II is equal to 0, I will be equal to IF. I will be equal to IF, and already we have calculated the value of that IF. So we will use that. Now, what is the value of this diode voltage? So for that, we need to apply one KVL over here. Apply one KVL in this particular. Starting with this node A. We are starting with this node A. Then only we can calculate. Our basic fundamental is that we need to calculate the value of final output. So for calculation of that final output, we apply one KVL over here. So starting with here, node A, so VA, then plus to minus minus VD, VD is voltage drop across the diode, VD, then plus to minus minus V output is equal to 0. So VA minus VD minus V output is equal to 0, but VA is connected to VB and VB is equal to 0. So VA will also be equal to 0. So VD will be equal to minus of V naught. VD is equal to what? VD is equal to minus of V naught. Or you can see from there also the diode negative terminal is connected to positive terminal of the output. By directly viewing the circuit diagram, you can make the assumption that the negative terminal of the diode is connected to the positive terminal of the output. So the sign would be just reverse. So VD will be equal to minus of V naught. Or V output will be how much? Already we have calculated the value of VD now in equation number A here. This is our VD when we have used the diode. So in case of the diode, what was the value of VD? VD is equal to eta VT log IF by I naught. Already we have calculated that. So now substituting that value over here. So minus of V naught will be equal to eta VT log IF divided by I naught. Or it can be written as V output is equal to eta VT log. What is IF? IF is equal to I from here. IF is equal to I, and already we have calculated the value of I. I is equal to Vin divided by R. So just we have substituted here the value of IF. We substituting the value of IF from here. Let's suppose this equation number one. So substituting the value of I from equation number two, equation number one to equation number two. So V output will be eta VT log Vin divided by R into I naught. Vin divided by R into I naught. If the value of R into I naught is, let the value of R into I naught is equal to V reference. Why it's V reference? V reference is a constant voltage now. Why? Because I naught is reverse saturation current and its value is in micro to nano ampere. So its value is fixed. It only depends in case of reverse biasing condition. The value of resistance is also fixed. So let we have chosen that the value as reference voltage, V reference. So R into I naught is equal to V reference. So from there V output will be minus of eta VT log V in divided by V reference. So this is the final value of output. Let this equation number three. So this is the final value of output of logarithmic amplifier using diode. Final value of output of logarithmic amplifier using diode. So this output equation depends on which parameter. So first parameter is eta. Eta is constant. No problem. Eta is constant. Second parameter is VT. VT is temperature dependent component. VT is temperature dependent. Why? Because already I told you VT is equal to KT divided by Q. So VT is KT divided by Q. That means it's a temperature dependent component. That means if the value of temperature is increasing or decreasing, so it will directly affect the output of the logarithmic amplifier and our calculation will be getting wrong. There is a chances for getting some wrong calculation at the output. So the value of that parameter should not be changed. You are getting my point now. VT is temperature dependent, and if there will be some changes into the value of temperature, the value of output will not be fixed. So we need to take care about this. So for that we will do something. Now third parameter is Vin. So Vin is input supply voltage, no problem. Fourth parameter is V reference. V reference is what? V reference is R into I naught, where R is constant, but I naught is reverse saturation current. I naught is what? I naught is reverse saturation current. And for every 10 degree centigrade rise in temperature, the value of reverse saturation current just doubles. Just double. When we increase the temperature by 10 degree centigrade, the value of reverse saturation current just double. That means it's also an temperature dependent component. That's why we need to move further for different kind of the circuit or some temperature compensated circuit. We need to move further for temperature compensated circuit. So we will discuss later the temperature compensated circuit. Before that, moving further to logarithmic amplifier voltage using transistors. So what is the problem? Temperature dependency, and we need to rectify about this VT and I naught from the output expression of the logarithmic amplifier. So that is our main aim. So before that, now calculating the value of output of the logarithmic amplifier using transistor. Why I am going from that way, not discussing about the temperature compensation? Why? Because first of all, I want to make you familiar with the basic calculation, the calculation which are interrelated to each other. So the output voltage calculation, basic fundamental of transistor and diode is same. So just I am first of all completing those parts. Then we will move further to temperature dependency. Why? Because there would be some, where their circuit would be something different. Two different kind of the circuit we need to study over there. So first of all, now we are going to calculate the logarithmic amplifier using transistor. So calculation is same. Here the value of current is I, and I is what? Vin minus it's VA. Let this VA. VA, this is VA. So Vin minus VA divided by R, or VA is equal to VB, so it that will be equal to zero. So Vin divided by R. Simply we have value of I, I is equal to IC. I is what? I is equal to IC due to this now I is equal to zero. So what is the value of VBE? Already we have calculated the value of VBE. Now VBE, how much is the value of VBE? VBE is equal to from here VT log IC divided by IS. So that is the value of VBE. So VBE is VT log IC divided by IS. Now what is IC? IC is equal to I, and I is equal to Vin divided by R. So now substituting the value of IC, simply substitute the value of IC. After substituting from here to there, VBE will be equal to VT log Vin divided by R into IS. The output is equal to VT log Vin divided by R into IS. Now one more thing, what would be the value of output? Why? Because mainly here we are going to calculate the value of the output. Now, so from this circuit only you can calculate the value of output. Apply KVL over here from this ground terminal to this ground terminal. Let the direction of the current is from here to there. Now, so this will be positive, this will be negative. Then the direction is from transistor terminal to the output. So plus to minus, minus VBE, plus to minus, minus V naught is equal to zero, or VBE is equal to what? VBE is equal to minus of V naught. Or you can see that the negative terminal of this transistor is connected to output terminal of the positive terminal of the output. That means the sign would be reverse. So the VBE will be equal to minus of V naught. So VBE is equal to minus of V naught. Same thing we are getting over here applying KVL. So VBE is equal to minus of V output. Already we have calculated the value of I. I is equal to Vin divided by R. Substituting these two values over here, the final value of output is so VT log Vin divided by R into IS. Again we are replacing it by reference voltage. R into IS is equal to V reference. So from there V output will be minus of VT log Vin divided by V reference. So you can see that both the expressions are same. Both the equations are same. Either you are using the diode or you are using the transistor, the expression for the output voltage in case of the logarithmic amplifier is same. What is the value of output? Output depends on the value of thermal voltage. Thermal voltage, and it is the log of the input voltage, log of the input voltage divided by V reference. V reference is R into IS. So here also the output voltage of the logarithmic amplifier depends on the value of VT. Depends on the value of VT, one of the temperature dependent component. Second thing, it is also dependent on the IS. IS is emitter reverse saturation current, which also increases by increasing the temperature by 10 degrees centigrade. It's also a temperature dependent component. So here also we need to use the temperature dependent circuit. So in both the cases, we need to use some temperature dependent component. So in next topic, we will start temperature dependent logarithmic amplifier. Temperature dependent logarithmic amplifier. So starting with temperature compensated logarithmic amplifier using diode. Temperature compensated logarithmic amplifier using diode. So from this first circuit is same. Let's suppose this first circuit is A1, circuit number 1. This is your logarithmic amplifier using diode. Already we have calculated the value of this V01. Already we have calculated the value of this V01. V0 is 1 is how much? This one. Now this is your temperature dependence. Second part of the circuit is, circuit number 2 is temperature dependent circuit, or temperature compensated circuit. So this circuit or the output circuit is used to compensate the effect of thermal voltage and reverse saturation current which is present at the output of the logarithmic amplifier. So let us discuss the operation of this circuit. So I think from here first circuit is clear to you. Now at the output terminal of the logarithmic amplifier, first of all we connect one diode. Let this diode is D2. The characteristic of that diode is same as the diode number 1. That means the characteristic of D1 and D2 both are same. Let the total voltage drop across this diode, or the diode voltage is represented as VF2. Here the value of diode voltage is VF2. At the anode terminal of the diode, we connect one dependent current source, I reference, constant current source. And here we let the value of voltage is VF. What is RT? RT is that thermistor. Here RT is thermistor. What is thermistor? I think I know, you know not what is thermistor. Thermistor is negative temperature coefficient of resistance. Thermistor is what? Thermistor is a negative temperature coefficient of resistance. That means if we are increasing the value of temperature, total resistance decreases, and if we decrease the value of temperature, resistance increases. So both are inverse to each other, negative temperature dependence. So VX, now the operational amplifier A2 is connected in non-inverting configuration. Which configuration it is connecting? It is connecting in non-inverting configuration. That means A2 is a non-inverting amplifier. A2 is what? A2 is a non-inverting amplifier. RF is a feedback element, and combination of R1 and RT produces the input impedance of the operational amplifier number 2. So this is the basic configuration of the circuit. This is the basic configuration of the circuit. And for calculating the final output voltage, V0, right? Because we need to calculate the final output, then only we can conclude now what are the dependence component, what are the component which are dependent on the output voltage. Now, so V0 is dependent on the value of VX, right? Because VX is the input to the operational amplifier number 2. So basic calculation, or the first of all, we need to calculate the value of this VX. So our main concentration is, first of all, we need to calculate the value of VX. And what is VX? VX is equal to V01 plus voltage drop across this VF2 or the diode. Voltage V01, already we have calculated the value of V01. Now we need to calculate the value of this VF2. So, but as I told you, the characteristic of both the diodes are same. The characteristic of both the diodes are same. That means the characteristic of VD1 is equal to same as VD2. That means the same voltage will be equal to VF1 will be equal to VF2. VF1 will be equal to VF2. So only we need to add V01 voltage with VF2 voltage, and we can calculate the value of VX. Then apply that VX at the input terminal of this transistor operational amplifier number 2, and from there we can calculate the output. So this is the basic procedure. So from the circuit, what is VX? VX is equal to V01 plus VF2. Now V01 we have calculated as this one. Now what is VF2? VF2 is equal to eta VT log IF2 divided by R0. In case of VF1, what was the value of VF1? On that condition, eta VT log IF divided by I0. Similarly, in case of the IF2, that will be IF2 divided by I0. So VF2 is equal to eta VT log IF2 divided by I0. So that is the value of total voltage drop across the diode number 2. Now IF2 is I reference. IF2 is what? I reference. Why? Because this is I reference is responsible for making the diode current. Generating total voltage drop across the diode. This is the responsible current. Now, so IF2 is equal to what? I reference. So we are replacing here the IF2 by I reference. So VF2 is equal to eta VT log I reference divided by I0. Now, substituting these two values in equation number 1, which is your equation number 1? This is our equation number 1. That means V01 plus VF2, substituting these two values. So this is the value of V01, this is the value of VF2. So after simplification, eta VT log Vin divided by R I0, V01 plus eta VT log I reference divided by I0. Now solve this by taking eta VT common, So log V in divided by R minus, why? Because we don't want this I naught. We don't want this I naught. That means that's why we are making it separate. So log V in divided by R minus log I naught. Then due to this minus sign, why? Because already we have taken this minus at the outer terminal. Na? So minus log I reference plus log I naught. Now this minus log I naught plus log I naught will be cancelled out. So Vx will be minus of eta Vt log V in by R minus log I reference, or it can be written as minus eta Vt log V in by R into I reference. V in by R into I reference. It is not written over here, but it can be written like that. So that is the value of Vx. So now we have calculated the value of Vx. Now we need to calculate the value of final output. What I told you, this is a non-inverting amplifier. It's a non-inverting amplifier. And in case of non-inverting amplifier, the value of output will be how much? 1 plus feedback resistance divided by input resistance multiplied by input voltage. So that is the value of output in case of non-inverting amplifier. So here Vin is equal to what? Vin is equal to Vx. And we have calculated the value of Vx. RF is what? RF is same as RF. What is Rin? Rin is series combination of R1 and RT. So V0 will be equal to Vx 1 plus RF divided by R1 plus RT. This is your input resistance, R1 plus RT. Feedback resistance is same, only RF. And input voltage is what? Input voltage is this Vx. Substituted the value of Vx. What is the value of Vx? I told you, na, Vx is equal to minus eta Vt log V in divided by R into I reference. Minus eta Vt log V in divided by R. I have made here after simplification, I have written here the value of Vx. So minus eta Vt log V in divided by R into I reference. That is the value of Vx. Now the simplification of this bracket is R1 plus RT plus R reference divided by R1 plus RT. So that is the value of output. This is the value of output. Now output is depending on what? Now output is depending on what? So you can see over here, before that, this one. In equation number 1, at the output are the, I think this calculation is divided into two parts. I left here one thing. So first discuss about this equation number 1, then we will go to equation number 2. When we have calculated the value of Vx, there was two temperature dependent parameter. The first parameter was Vt and second parameter was I naught. So two parameters were temperature dependent, and we need to rectify or we need to eliminate these parameters from the output. So when we have calculated the value of Vx or the equation number 1, so from equation number 1 you can see that it is dependent on Vt only. This equation number 1 depends on Vt only, and the value of I naught already eliminated from the calculation. That means when we have calculated the value of Vx, first one of the element we have rectified. So if we will move up to here, or if we design the circuit up to here on that condition, reverse saturation current will not be the part of Vt, is the part of the output. Up to the calculation of equation number 1, Vt is the part of the output calculation. So this circuit number 2 is used to eliminate the value of Vt. So after this, when we are calculating the final equation, equation number 2, you can see over here that it depends on Vt. It depends on Vt, but it also depends on this RT. What is RT? Already I told you, RT is negative temperature coefficient of resistance. RT is what? Negative temperature coefficient of resistance. So as the value of Vt increasing, as the value of Vt increasing, the value of this RT will be decreasing. as the value of temperature is increasing, voltage will increase, but indirectly value of total RT will be decreased. So due to that, this will compensate the effect of VT. This will compensate the effect of VT, and overall this output will not be dependent on temperature. So this whole the parameter we can take as constant. Now this term will be constant. Why? Because VT and RT both compensated the effect of each other, and when they compensated the effect of each other, there is no any dependency of the temperature in the final expression of the output. So this is the basic fundamental and behind the calculation of output or the temperature compensated logarithmic amplifier using diode. To make it clear, you can think that here VT is present now, but indirectly it is also dependent on RT, and both cancelled out each other. Now the temperature compensated logarithmic amplifier using transistor. So up to now we have completed the logarithmic amplifier, temperature compensated logarithmic amplifier using diode. Now last topic is temperature compensated logarithmic amplifier using transistor. So there are two types of the circuits are present for compensation of the temperature using transistor. One circuit is what, in which we use the four diode, four operational amplifier, which is shown over here. One of the more circuit is there which only includes two operational amplifier. Here we are discussing only the generalized circuit for the temperature compensation logarithmic amplifier using transistor, that means with the help of four operational amplifier. So in this circuit, these two operational amplifier are nothing but the logarithmic amplifier using transistor. This is logarithmic amplifier number one using transistor. This is logarithmic amplifier using transistor number two. In upper circuit, the value of input voltage is Vin. In lower circuit, the value of input voltage is V reference. And the output of these two logarithmic amplifier is applied to which circuit? This is a difference amplifier, no? This is a difference amplifier. So output of both the logarithmic amplifier is applied to the input terminal of difference amplifier, and you can see that all the four resistances of this difference amplifier is same. All the four resistances of this difference amplifier is same. That means what is the value of this Vx, output of this difference amplifier? Output of this difference amplifier is Vx. Vx is equal to what? Rf divided by R1 or Rin, positive terminal or non-inverting terminal voltage minus inverting terminal voltage. This is the expression for the output in case of the difference amplifier. What is Rf and Rin? Both are same. That means it would be cancelled out. So what is Vx? Vx is equal to V02. Vx will be equal to V02, and V minus is what? V minus is equal to V01. So already we have calculated the value of V01 and V02. Only we need to substitute these values. So if we will make the difference of these two voltages, easily we can calculate the value of Vx. This is the basic procedure for the calculation of the output. So from there we can calculate the value of Vx. Now Vx is applied to the input terminal of operational amplifier number 4. Vx is applied at the input terminal of operational amplifier number 4. But I think there is problem in the sign of the op amp. It's also an, I think, inverting, not inverting, it's a non-inverting amplifier. So this sign is positive and this sign would be negative. So output operational amplifier is also a non-inverting amplifier, and in case of non-inverting amplifier, output will be how much? 1 plus Rf by Rin into Vx. Why? Because here the value of Vin is equal to Vx. So that is the value of final output. So Rf is equal to RT, Rin is, Rf is equal to here R2, and Rin is equal to RT. And Vx, by the difference of V01 and V02, we have calculated the value of Vx. So finally from there we can calculate the value of output. So this is the basic procedure for the calculation of total output. I think that would be clear to all of you. Let's see the complete solution of this circuit. So already we have calculated the value of V01 in case of the transistor. So using transistor, the value of output number one is minus VT log Vin divided by R1 IS. in case of when the value of input voltage is Vin. Now what is the value of V output? Here the value of input voltage is V reference. So minus VT log V reference divided by R1 into IS. So these are the values of V01 and V02. Now operational amplifier third is what? It's a difference amplifier. And as I told you, all the resistances are same due to that Vx is equal to Vg02 minus Vg01. So from there, just substitute the value of Vg02 and Vg01 here. So by substituting the value and make some simplification, substitute the values and make some simplification, you can easily calculate or do that part. Na? So from there, the value of Vx, finally, I am showing you the final expression for the output. The final expression for the output, this Vx. Vx will be what? Vt log. Here the value of Vx is minus Vt log V reference divided by Vin. But for compensating this minus sign, we have changed the position, interchanged the position of the voltage. So when it is Vin divided by V reference, sign would be positive. So Vx is equal to Vt log Vin divided by V reference. So we have calculated the value of Vx. Now third part is, we need to calculate the output. And as I told you, this is positive terminal, make the correction. And this is your negative terminal. Why? Because it's a non-inverting amplifier. And output of non-inverting amplifier is Vn 1 plus Rf by R1. So here Rf is what? Rf is equal to R2, this one. And Rin is equal to what? Rt. And Vin is equal to what? This Vx. And already we have calculated the value of Vx. So substitute the value of Vx. So V output will be Vt log Vin divided by V reference 1 plus R2 divided by Rt. Or here also you will get the term as Vt 1 plus R2 divided by Rt. But same as in case of the diode, as I told you, Vt and Rt both will compensate the effect of each other. Both the term will compensate the effect of each other. That's why here I have taken it as K. What is the value of this K? K will be equal to Vt multiplied by this term. So the multiplication of these two terms is equal to K. So K into log Vin divided by V reference. So the output expression of this temperature compensated logarithmic amplifier depends only on the value of input voltage and the reference voltage. So there is no any chances for change in the value of output due to temperature. So these are the values of the output. Or these are the derivation and the calculation part of the output of logarithmic amplifier. So today we have discussed about the logarithmic amplifier using diode, logarithmic amplifier using transistor, calculated the output voltage in case of the diode, in case of the transistor. Also we have compensated the effect of temperature in logarithmic amplifier using diode and logarithmic amplifier using transistor. So that much of the theoretical part we have completed today. Now it's time for two problems. I have two problems for you related to this logarithmic amplifier. These are some good problems. So just within 5 minutes, we discuss these two problems. So question number one, in the op-amp circuit shown in the figure, assume that the diode current follows the equation I is equal to Is e to the power V divided by Vt. So this is the value of diode current. I think you are familiar this equation already. Just before that, we have calculated the value of that current. Now, I is equal to Is e to the power V divided by Vt. Condition is that when Vin is equal to 2 volt, what is the value of output? Output is equal to Vg01. When we have substituted the value of Vin is equal to 2 volt, what will be the value of output? Output is equal to Vg01. But when Vin is equal to 4 volt, output will be what? Output is equal to Vg02. Now we need to make a relationship in between V01 and V02. We need to make a relationship in between V01 and V02. So what we need to do? First of all, calculate V01, then calculate V02. Already we have calculated this part. Already we have derived the expression for output voltage in case of logarithmic amplifier using diode. Same thing you need to do. Finally, what do you need? In case of V01, you need to substitute the value of Vin as 2 volt. And when you are calculating V02 only, you need to substitute the value of Vin as 4 volt. This is only change into the problem. just see the solution. So apply KCL here at, let's suppose it is node A, this current is I, and here the value of current is ID, diode current. So when you apply KCL at A, so I is equal to ID. What is I? I is equal to Vin minus VA divided by R, Vin minus VA divided by R, and ID, the value of ID is given. Diode current is given as IS e to the power V divided by AT. E to the power VD divided by AT. I have changed it in our calculation part. So here VD is equal to what? VT plus 2 minus, this term is plus, terminal is plus 2 minus. That means negative terminal is connected to positive. That means VD is equal to minus of V0. So we have substituted here VD is equal to minus of V0. You can, by applying the KVL also you can calculate this value. Already I think we have calculated that. So due to virtual ground, this VA is connected to VB. So that is equal to 0. So we make it VA is equal to 0. So expression will be Vin divided by R, and R is equal to 2A. So Vin divided by 2K is equal to I0 e to the power. VT is replaced by this minus of V output. So minus of V output divided by VT. Now take the natural log. After taking the natural log, already we have derived this expression. As per the output expression of the diode, what is the value of output? Minus of eta VT log Vin divided by R I0. That is the expression for the output. So here the value of eta is not given. So we have chosen here the value of eta is equal to 1. Eta is equal to 1. So V output is equal to minus of VT log Vin divided by 2K into I0. So this is the generalized expression for the output. Now apply these relationships. So when Vin is equal to 2 volt, so when we substituted here Vin is equal to 2 volt, on that condition this is the value of V01. On that condition output will be what? Output will be represented as V01. So minus of VT log 2 divided by 2K into I0, or it can be written as minus of VT log 2 minus VT log, when the bracket is here it is not, it should not be, you know, 2K into I0. So this is equation number 1. Now when Vin is equal to 4 volt, output will be what? Output is equal to V02. So V02 is minus VT log when 4 is this one. So this is equation number 1 and this is equation number 2. For generating a relationship in between V01 and V02, just we take the difference, and when you take the difference, output will be minus of VT log 2. Minus of VT log 2. So only you need to remember, or you need to calculate the final output voltage of logarithmic amplifier by simple calculation, calculate the value of its output and then substitute the value. Easily from there you can calculate the value of output. This question is related to GATE 2007. This question was related to GATE 2007. I have referred this question from there. This is your question number 1. Now last question, question number 2. Here what you need to do, one IV characteristic of the diode is given, same as the previous one. I is equal to I0 e to the power VT divided by eta VT minus 1. Here the value of beta is 25 millivolt. The value of VT is given as 25 millivolt. The value of reverse saturation current is given as 1 microampere. And V is what? V is the voltage of the diode. Voltage of the diode is V. And when the diode is in forward biasing condition, when the diode will be in forward biasing condition, on that condition total voltage drop across the diode is given as V. Input voltage is given as minus 1 volt. Here we need to calculate the value of output. So simple question, only we need to calculate the output, and for calculation of this output just apply one KVL. So by applying that KVL or basic rule we can calculate the value of output. So this is the solution of this question. So as we have started earlier all the calculation by the same way, we are using all we are also calculating the value of output here only. So apply KCL at node A. So let the value of current here, the value of current, it is this current is I1. This current is, suppose I. Why? Because I have mentioned here I and I1. Na? this current is I and this current is I1. These are the current. So I at node A, when we apply KCL, I plus I1 is equal to 0. I plus I1 is equal to 0. What is I? So I is the diode current. So already we have calculated that part. So not, we are not going over there. Here it is the value of diode current. Only we are calculating the value of I1. I1 is equal to what? Vin minus VA divided by 100K. Vin minus VA divided by 100K, and as VA is equal to 0, so I will be how much? Minus of Vin divided by 100K. And what is Vin? Vin is given as minus 1. So minus, minus 1 divided by 100K, from there I will be equal to 100 microampere. So we have calculated the value of 10 microampere. So we have calculated the value of I. I is 10 microampere. Here the relationship of I and diode current is given. And diode current is equal to input current. Why? Because input current of the op amp is equal to 0. So this input current is equal to I. So I is equal to I naught e to the power V divided by Vt minus 1. Or V will be equal to Vt log 1 plus I divided by I naught. You may calculate this value. No? Calculate the value of this parameter. Take the natural log, and by taking the natural log, you can calculate this expression. I am not going over there. So V is equal to Vt log 1 plus I divided by I naught. Already we have calculated the value of I. I is 10 microampere. What is I naught? I naught is given as 1 microampere. So substituted here the value of I, from there 10 microampere. I naught is equal to 1 microampere. So micro, micro is cancelled out. That means 10 divided by 1. And the value of Vt, Vt is given as 25 millivolt. So substituted the value of Vt as 25 millivolt. So from there, the diode voltage is 0.06 volt. Diode voltage is what? 0.06 volt. Now, we have calculated the value of V. But what is V? V is the potential difference across this diode. V is what? V is the potential difference across this diode, where the direction of this current is from output terminal to input. Why? Because input is current connected to zero. This VA is connected to zero. And for negative supply, when the cycle is negative, for that output will be what? Positive. Why? Because it is connected to inverting terminal of op-amp. And in case of inverting terminal of op-amp, there is a phase shift of 180 degree in between input and output. So for negative cycle, we will get the positive half-cycle. So output is at higher potential. Output will be at higher potential. So V naught minus VA, that is equal to total drop over here. What is the value of total drop? 4K multiplied by I plus diode voltage. Drop across this plus diode voltage is equal to V naught minus VA. So V naught minus VA is equal to 4000 I plus V. Substitute the value of I from here. Substitute the value of V from there. And calculate, simplify all the calculation. This is the final value of. I hope that would be clear to you. Whatever given to you, just substitute all the values and calculate the final expression. This question is related to GATE 2008. So these questions are related to logarithmic amplifier. I hope that much part would be clear to you. Today's test will be conducted in the same manner, that means at 1 o'clock, when the third lecture would be completed. Just give me a message, I will distribute the link for the quiz. So thank you so much for today.